Greetings, Two Stroke fans. A very quick update here. This is just a progress report on the software, the Two Stroke Expansion Chamber Calculator. It's about a week off. There's a couple of little things I want to do, but I just want to give you a quick run through of the software. It's basically fairly simple. You just put your port timing in, RPM, exhaust temperature. These things I'll explain in due course. I just left them open so that you can edit them if you want to. It's got a help system. You just wave over the window and it'll tell you what each box is in expanded form and explanatory. So that's the help system. So it won't have a separate help file. So you just wave it over if you want to use that. I'll just do a quick demo. 180, the tab keys work in order, so you can just use keyboard if you want. 10,000, we'll use 500 C's. I'll put the designations in there for temperature in Celsius, but it's all metric. Exhaust port 32, 20. I might put a converter in there for Imperial, I'm not sure yet. And then we can just hit pipe calculator and get a pipe. So that gives us our pipe, the lengths of each of the cones, dimensions up here. Yeah, you can copy that if you want. Just a quick run through of the other windows, input calculator, input values calculations. Okay, this is for the input values, port timing and exhaust temperature. So, and exhaust port diameter, okay. So the first one is for calculating the exhaust port diameter from the exhaust port area. So it's just a handy calculator that makes it a bit easier. You just put in the curved. When you get a piece of paper and you put it inside the bore and you mark the piece of paper, then you measure the width of the port, as I've explained in the video series on the equations that are used in this and how to do that. So you can have a look at those videos if you haven't yet. This will just calculate the chordal width, which is the width straight across that we use for the software purposes in here. Then once we know our width and our port height, we can add the radius sizes of the ports. Again, I've explained that in videos. That will give us an output of our port window area, and then we get our port window diameter, and that's the port window diameter at the piston. Okay, and that's added in there. So that gives you a way to calculate that. You can also put in a width and port height here and radiuses, etc., to get a port window diameter. If your outlet port here, that's the outlet where the flange is on the head, is not round. So you can do the same for that. This calculator, BMEP, we can calculate from our engine kilowatt, rated kilowatts, RPM, bore, stroke length. We can get our BMEP bar in pressure. If you know what the BMEP is, you can just add it in there and get the estimated exhaust temperature. So that's to put the exhaust temperature into here. So that just helps you calculate that. Exhaust port timing calculator here to put the timing value in. Stroke length, conrod length, deck height, top of cylinder, the top of the port. Exhaust port height itself. Again, that's the same as that, port height. And from that, we can hit the button and we can get their exhaust port degrees, in crankshaft degrees, to put into here. If we've got the crankshaft degrees and we've measured it with a degree wheel, we can put it in there, put the stroke, conrod length in, hit the button there, and it'll give us the actual top of the cylinder and the exhaust port height so that we can actually physically measure those as a cross-check. Just to double check that we've got the timing measured exactly and properly, if you need to, because it's fairly critical to get the exhaust port timing measured correctly to put into the software. Enough, we'll move on. Next one is the cone calculators. I've shown you this one before in other videos, but it's just a side calculator if you've got an expansion chamber already on a bike and you want to measure the angle of the cone that you've got on a certain expansion chamber. You don't know what it is, the diffuser cone, and you want to know what the angle is. You might want to change it or something. Then you can just get the diameters of the tip and the base of the cone. If you know what the angle is, then you can get the centre length of the cone, calculate that. Otherwise, you can measure, if you know what the centre length is, it's a bit hard to measure when the pipe's all complete. So if you just put the side length in, measure from here across, you know, the sideways length, and hit the button, you can get the actual angle of the cone to find out what it is. You may use it, you may not use it. It's just, it's there. Another one is we can open a pipe and save a pipe. So once we put all the numbers in, we can just save that, name it if we want. If we've got different pipes, you might want to open again and make some changes and then calculate another pipe size. So once we've calculated our pipe, we can then go to flat cone plot, open it here. Now, this gives you the dimensions if you want to draw on a piece of paper using a compass, okay? Some softwares print this out, but it's a bit big in some cases for an A4 piece of paper, so unless you've got a plotter, it's pretty useless printing it out. So I'm going to show you when I upload the software, which will be about a week. A couple of things to do to it yet. I'll show you how to do this with a compass and a ruler. It's very, very easy. And you just draw the piece of paper, you put it over a bit of sheet metal, and then scribe that down, cut out your piece of sheet metal, and then you roll your cone. So if you just want to make one cone, you can put the base tip diameters of the cone in, the length, center length of the cone, and hit the single plot and hit the plot cone and get a and get the values you need for A, D, B, and C. But we've got four cones here, L2, L3, L4, and L6. So in this case, we just hit batch, hit plot cone, and that gives us all of our cones, L2, L3, L4, and L6. And that gives us our A, B, C, and D dimensions. So we can just go like that, copy that, put it into a notepad, print it out so that we can make our cones from that. So that just makes that a little bit easier. And other option I was going to add is if you want a straight header, okay, if you don't want a header, this L1, okay, if you don't want L1 to be smaller and larger according to the port to pipe ratio, you just want a straight header, I'll just put an option in there. You can just click on that to make that a straight header, because keep in mind that that exhaust port window is the diameter from D1 is from taken from the exhaust port window, not the exhaust port outlet at the edge of the head. So, and say if the exhaust port outlet here at the edge of the head was larger, we have a pipe that goes actually smaller, and we don't want to do that. So you can just click on straight header, and that'll just make sure that the header's straight, and that will make sure that the numbers all gel. And yeah, that's just a quick run through. I'll do a more comprehensive explanation and show you how the software works when I upload it. It's going to be free and won't be too far off. So that will do it for now. Okay, bye for now.